We will now discuss the applications of adsorption in pollution control. In the first module, we will discuss about adsorption in general, and in the second module, we take a case study on adsorption of volatile organic compounds in fixed beds. In adsorption process, one or more components of a gas or liquid are adsorbed on the surface of a solid adsorbent and a separation is accomplished. Applications of liquid phase adsorption include removal of organic compounds from water or organic solutions, colored impurities from organics, and various fermentation products for fermenter effluents. Applications of gas phase adsorption include removal of water from hydrocarbon gases, sulfur compounds from natural gas, solvents from air and other gases, and odors from air. Many adsorbents have been developed for a wide range of applications. Typically, the adsorbents are in the form of small pellets, beads, or granules ranging from 0.1 mm to 12 mm in size, with the large particles being used in packet beds. A particle of adsorbent has a very porous structure with many fine pores and pore volumes up to 50% of the total particle volume. Adsorbent pores. The total number of pores, their shape and size determine the adsorption capacity and even the dynamic adsorption rate of the adsorbent. The range of pore sizes, which is defined according to the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, that is IUPAC, is summarized in this table. They are classified as ultra micro pores with pore width less than 0.7 nanometers, super micro pores with pore width between 0.7 to 2 nanometers, micro pores with pore width less than 0.2 nanometers, mesopores with pore width between 2 to 50 nanometers, and finally, the macro pores with pore width greater than 50 nanometers. The IUPAC classification of pores is shown in this table. A schematic representation of the porous structure of the adsorbent is shown in the next figure. Adsorbent surface area. A schematic representation of the external and internal adsorbent surface is shown in this figure. The specific surface area is another important property that determines adsorbent usage and its capacity. The total surface area of activated carbon, for example, ranges from 500 to 2000 meter square per gram, that quantifies adsorption site for molecules to attach. The micropores usually provide the largest proportion of the internal surface of the activated carbon and contribute to most of the total pore volume. Mesopores, macropores, and the non-porous surface of the sample represent the external surface. Despite most of the adsorption takes place in the micropores, the meso and macropores play an important role in the adsorption process because they serve as passage for the adsorbent to reach the micropores. Moreover, the multilayer adsorption only takes place in meso and macropores. The adsorption often occurs as a monolayer on the surface of fine pores. However, several layers sometimes occur. Physical adsorption or van der Waals adsorption usually occurs between the adsorbed molecules and the solid internal pore surface and is readily reversible. When the molecules of the adsorbate are held to the surface of the adsorbent by the chemical forces, the adsorption is called chemical adsorption or chemisorption. The differences between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption are listed in this table. The forces between the adsorbent molecules and the adsorbent are weak van der Waals forces in the case of physical adsorption, whereas in chemical adsorption the forces between the adsorbent molecules and the adsorbent are strong chemical forces. The heat of adsorption in the case of physical adsorption is low and is in the order of 20 to 40 kilojoules per mole. In chemical adsorption, the heat of adsorption is high and is in the order of 200 to 400 kilojoules per mole. Physical adsorption usually occurs at low temperatures and decreases with increasing temperatures. The chemical adsorption occurs at high temperatures. The physical adsorption is reversible and the chemical adsorption is irreversible. The extent of adsorption depends upon the ease of liquefaction of the gases in the case of physical adsorption, whereas in the case of chemisorption, there is no correlation between the extent of adsorption and the ease of liquefaction of gases. Physical adsorption is less specific in nature and all gases are adsorbed on the surface of a solid to some extent. The chemical adsorption is highly specific in nature and occurs only when there is a bond formation between adsorbent and adsorbent molecules. Physical adsorption forms multi-molecular layers, whereas chemical adsorption forms monomolecular layer. The extent of adsorption increases with pressure both in the case of physical adsorption and in the chemical adsorption. There are a number of commercial adsorbents and some of them are shown here. They are activated carbon, silica gel, activated alumina, molecular sieve zeolites, etc. All these adsorbents are characterized by very large pore surface areas of 100 to over 200 meters square per gram. How the adsorption occurs? What is the adsorption mechanism? The adsorption process of the adsorbed molecules from the bulk liquid phase into the adsorbent surface is presumed to involve four stages. In the first stage, the mass transfer of the adsorbed molecules across the external boundary layer towards the solid particle. The second stage is in which adsorbent molecules transport from the particle surface into the active sites by diffusion within the pore-filled liquid and migrate along the solid surface of the pore. In the third step, the solute molecules adsorption on the active sites and on the interior surface of the pores. And finally, in the fourth step, once the molecule is adsorbed, it may migrate on the pore surface through surface diffusion. This is shown schematically in the next figure. Competitive adsorption. When an adsorbent is in contact with more than one species, say adsorbate, there will be competition among them to get adsorbed on the surface of the adsorbent. The one that is more strongly adsorbed gets deposited first in preference to the others. Further, a strongly adsorbed substance may displace a weakly adsorbed substance. For example, ammonia can displace oxygen or nitrogen from the surface of charcoal. In the cases of gases and solids, the extent of adsorption of a gas on a solid surface is affected by the nature of the gas, that is the nature of the adsorbent. The easily liquefiable gases such as HCl, ammonia and chlorine etcetera are adsorbed more than the permanent gases such as hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. The ease with which a gas can be liquefied is primarily determined by its critical temperature. Higher the critical temperature of a gas, the more easily it will be liquefied and therefore more readily it will be adsorbed on the solid. Now, we will discuss the equilibrium relationship. The equilibrium between the concentration of a solute in the fluid phase and the concentration on the solid phase are plotted as adsorption isotherms and some commonly types, namely the Freundlich and the Langmuir isotherms, are shown in this figure. The concentration in the solid phase is expressed as Q, kg of adsorbate for kg of adsorbent. The concentration in the liquid phase is expressed as C, that is so many kg of adsorbate per meter cube of fluid. The Freundlich isotherm, isotherm which is empirical, often approximates data for many physical adsorbent systems and is particularly used for liquids. Q equals to K C raised to N. Here, Q is the concentration in the solid phase, C is the concentration in the liquid phase. The two constants K and N must be determined experimentally. The Langmuir isotherm has a theoretical basis and is given by the equation shown here, Q equals to Q naught C by K plus C. Here, Q naught is a constant and has units of so many kgs of adsorbate per kg of solids, C is the concentration in the liquid phase and K is a constant and assumes the values of kg per meter cube. The equation was derived assuming that there are only a fixed number of active sites available for adsorption, only monolayer is formed and the adsorption is reversible and reaches an equilibrium condition. Almost all adsorption systems show that as temperature increases, the amount adsorbed by the adsorbent decreases strongly. This is useful since adsorption is normally at room temperatures and desorption can be attained by raising the temperature. Now, we will discuss the thermodynamics of adsorption. Finding thermodynamic parameters for adsorption helps differentiating the physical adsorption from chemical adsorption and also helps predicting the adsorption behavior in relevant conditions and different temperatures. Finding the equilibrium constant at different temperatures allows calculation of change in standard Griffith energy, standard entropy and standard enthalpy. Adsorption of model compounds and adsorbent can be represented with the reversible equilibrium function as shown here. When an aqueous phase containing a solute comes into contact with an adsorbent, transfer of the solute from aqueous phase to the surface of the adsorbent and also the reverse process occurs as solute in aqueous phase is in equilibrium with solute on adsorbent surface. This is due to the higher affinity of solute to the surface of the adsorbent than water and the higher concentration of solute in the bulk of the liquid. solute molecules will be transferred between the interface of the adsorbent and the bulk of the liquid until an equilibrium is attained. At equilibrium, equal amounts of solute will be adsorbed and desorbed. Consequently, the concentration of solute in bulk aqueous phase and an adsorbent surface will remain constant. The apparent equilibrium constant denoted by Kc prime for each equilibrium concentration of solute in liquid phase is defined as concentration of solute on adsorbent surface divided by the concentration of solute in the liquid phase. That is, Kc prime equals to concentration of solute on adsorbent surface divided by concentration of solute in aqueous solution. In order to obtain the standard thermodynamic equilibrium constant denoted by Kc naught, the activity should be used instead of concentration of a model compound as shown herein. The thermodynamic equilibrium constant Kc naught equals to As by Ae, that is equal to gamma S by gamma E multiplied by Cs by Ce. In this equation for standard thermodynamic equilibrium constant, As is the activity of solute on adsorbent, Ae is the activity of solute in solution, gamma S is the activity of solute on adsorbent, and gamma E is the activity coefficient of solute in solution, and Cs is the concentration of solute on adsorbent, and C is the concentration of solute in solution. The apparent equilibrium constant Kc prime values for differential initial concentrations of the model compounds are obtained by extrapolation when the initial concentration of model compound in solution at equilibrium approaches 0. This value is equal to the intercept of the linear form of Langmuir model. This is given by Ce by Qe equals to 1 by Q naught plus Ce by Q naught. Knowing the intercept of the linear form of Langmuir curve, the standard equilibrium constant Kc naught will be Q naught, as we had discussed earlier in the case of Langmuir isotherm. Finding the standard equilibrium constant for any temperature, the standard free energy will be calculated from the equation shown here. Delta G equals to minus RT ln Kc naught, delta G equals to delta H naught minus T delta S. R in the above equation is a gas constant and assumes the values of 0.008314 kilojoules per Kelvin per mole and T the absolute temperature in Kelvin. Knowing the relationship between the standard Gibbs free energy, standard enthalpy and standard entropy, from these equations, the values of delta H naught and delta S naught of adsorption can be calculated from the slope and intercept of the Van't Hoff's plot of ln Kc naught versus 1 by T, as shown here. This is Van't Hoff's equation. Ln Kc naught equals to delta S naught by R minus delta H naught by RT. From the above equation, the standard enthalpy change delta H naught, so many kilojoules per mole, is negative of the slope of the trend line multiplied by R, and the standard entropy delta S naught expressed in kilojoules per mole per Kelvin is intercept of the trend line multiplied by R. The units of standard enthalpy change delta H net R so many kilojoules per mole. What is the effect of temperature on adsorption? Mostly the process of adsorption is exothermic and the reverse process or desorption is endothermic. If the above equilibrium is subjected to increase in temperature, then according to Lee-Chatier's principle, with increase in temperature the desorption will be favored. Physical adsorption decreases continuously with increase in temperature, whereas chemical adsorption increases initially, shows a maximum in the curve and then decreases continuously. So the variation of extent of adsorption with temperature is shown in these figures. The initial increase in chemical adsorption with increase in temperature is because of activation energies required. This is why chemical adsorption is also known as activated adsorption. A graph between the degree of adsorption and temperature at a constant pressure of adsorbate gas is known as adsorption isobar, where x is the moles of adsorbate and m is the mass of adsorbent. The effect of pressure. The extent of adsorption of a gas per unit mass of adsorbent depends upon the pressure of the gas. The variation of extent of adsorption expressed as x by m and the pressure is shown here. Here x is the moles of adsorbate and m is the mass of adsorbent. A graph between the amount of adsorption and gas pressure keeping the temperature constant is called an adsorption isotherm. It is clear from the figure that the extent of adsorption, that is x by m, increases with pressure and becomes maximum corresponding to a pressure P s called the equilibrium pressure. Since adsorption is a reversible process, the desorption also takes place simultaneously. At this pressure P s, the amount of gas adsorbed becomes equal to the amount of gas desorbed. The variation of extent of adsorption with pressure is shown in this figure. Pressure swing adsorption. Although adsorption is most often used as a purification process to remove small amount of material, a number of applications involving separation of gas mixtures with moderate to high concentration of adsorbents. These are called bulk separations and they often use different operating procedures than for gas purification. Pressure swing adsorption is a bulk separation process that is used for small scale air separation plants and for concentration of hydrogen in process streams.